Myself Nivedita Joshi. Today I'm going to take the topic agents of pollination. In this topic we will cover abiotic and biotic agents. First of all we will take abiotic agents like wind and water, and out of these two the wind is most common type of agent. The flowers which are pollinated by wind, they are called as anemophilous flower, and such a phenomena is called as anemophily. The flower should have certain features for the successful pollination, like the flower should produce enormous amount of pollen grains, and pollen grains should be light in weight as well as non-sticky. They have well-exposed stamens and the feathery stigma. Oftenly, single ovule is seen in each ovary and the flowers are clustered in inflorescence. The examples for anemophilous flowers are grasses, wheat, paddy and maize. One important thing is here, in the corn cob we see tassels. The tassels are actually style and stigma. The plants or the flowers which are pollinated by water are called as hydrophilous flowers, and such a phenomena is hydrophily. Though it is very rare in flowering plants and it is seen mostly in monocotyledons. It is not like that all aquatic plants use water as agency. There are certain features which will make the hydrophily successful, that is pollen grains should be long, ribbon like, and they should have the mucilaginous coverings so that they can be prevented from getting wet. And the flowers, they do not have any kind of nectars. The examples are Vallisneria, Jostera and Hydrophily. Now biotic agents, so many biotic agents are there, like insects, birds, bats, etc. If they are pollinated by insects, they are called as entomophilous flowers, or phenomena is entomophily. In the insects, the bees are dominating pollinating agent. The features in insect pollinated flowers are, flowers are large, they are brightly colored, they have fragrance and they are rich in nectar. If the flowers are small, then they are found in the clusters. Their pollen grains are sticky and edible to the pollinators. The examples for entomophily are yucca, rose, magnolia, aster, sunflower, etc. Bird pollinating plants. Sunbirds and hummingbirds are most common pollinating agents. And in the ornithophilous flowers, the flowers are large, they are beautifully colored, and the flowers are with the long tubular structures, and they have nectar as a reward for the birds. The examples for ornithophilous flowers are bottle brush, daylilies, and lupins. Some plants are there which are pollinated by bats, and such a phenomena is called as chiropterophily. Especially in this category, night blooming flowers having the fragrance, they are pollinated by the bats. The most common, it is seen in tropical and desert areas. The bats especially, which love nectar, they just visit such kind of plants And the plants which are pollinated by bats are mango, agave, guava, banana. Now here is assignment after going through the topic agents for the pollination. So these are the some of the questions which you can try for.